EditReady is designed to simplify any workflow, from the most basic to the most advanced. To show you how you can use EditReady in a more advanced workflow, I'm going to walk through a scenario. To start with, I'm going to add some media by dragging it in from Finder. I've got some GoPro files, some iPhone files, and some Blackmagic cinema camera files. The Blackmagic camera files are my A camera, and the other cameras are my sort of B camera pickup shots. To start with, I want to set a real name on these files so I can tell them apart in the post-production process. I'm going to select the Blackmagic camera files, flag them, and then say set metadata for flagged. Within the clip category, I can find the real dropdown, and I'm going to set these as real A camera. I'm going to repeat the same process for the other files and set them as the B camera. Now, within my NLE, I can quickly tell apart my A camera and B camera files. Next, I'd like to learn a little bit more about my media, so I'm going to bring up the Edit Metadata window by selecting it from the Clip menu. Here, I can see all of the metadata that's attached to my clip, including that real name that I just set. Now, some of this information doesn't look quite right. I think the camera had some defaults set. I'll press the Delete key to clear it out. Also, this angle isn't a close-up, so I'm going to click to edit it and change it to a medium shot. I could add additional keys by clicking the plus button in the upper right corner. Now, you'll notice that creation date says it has conflicting values. If I click the disclosure triangle, I can see there are two different dates attached to this file. That's pretty common. By clicking the checkbox to the right of the date, I can choose the override value and make sure that this same date is used in all of the places within the file that store a date. I can do this for any metadata key that has a conflict. Next, I want to take a closer look at my video, so I'm going to bring up the preview window. This footage was shot in the log space, so it has a sort of flat look. I can load a production LUT to get a sense of how it's going to look once the colorist has done their work. This quickly lets me see how my footage will look after it's been graded, so I can make sure it's exactly what I expect. Next, I want to actually make some dailies with these files, so I can share that look with other people in the production. I'm going to select those Blackmagic camera files again, and I'll flag them. And I want to set my output format to H.264. I'll load that LUT, and now I want to customize my file name so I know exactly what these files are. I'm going to bring up the metadata window again and add the real key to my file name. That way I'll be able to tell these different cameras apart. I'm also going to add the word daily so that I can know that these are the dailies and not my finished product. I'll click Convert Flagged and start that batch going. Now I'm going to create a second batch with my ProRes format. I'll select ProRes from the dropdown. I'm not going to load a LUT this time, but I do want to add that real key again. Now I'll just add a dash and hit Convert All. EditReady is now converting my files to both H.264 for those Blackmagic camera files, as well as ProRes for all of my files, so I'm grading dailies as well as my finished editable format. I could create more batches to create online and offline files, or create dailies for everything, or create one set of dailies with one set of file names and another with a different set of file names. EditReady is incredibly powerful and incredibly flexible. If I open Finder, you can see that my files are already appearing with the file names that I specified, and I could even start watching them right away. We're really excited to share EditReady with the world, and we can't wait to see how other people use the application within their post-production workflows. If you'd like to give EditReady a try yourself, to see exactly how it can speed up your own workflows, visit www.divergentmedia.com/editready. Please let us know what you think, and we can't wait to see what you do with the tool. Thanks for watching.